and stored to the council website. If any member, officer or member of the public addressing the committee has a concern with this, please contact the committee service officer immediately. For those at home viewing the webcast, I would like to inform you that if you look above the video, you will see a resources tab. Select this link to the agenda will appear, and on the inner right hand side, this will allow you to open the agenda in PDF form and follow the discussion and debate. Members, when voting on items for consideration, I intend to take this by assent unless a proposal that differs from the officer recommendation is moved. Item two is apologies. Do we have any apologies this evening? No? Okay, thank you. Members' code of conduct, declaration of interest. Do any members have a declaration of interest? Thank you.
I'd like to declare an interest in IT10, a non-prejudicial interest by virtue of being the school governor. Thank you.
Declare our seat after an interest in the program.
Yeah, same interest on the world growth company. I've already, as a director, like to consider the accounts from start of off. So it would be a bit odd for us here discussing it and to tell you all how I felt. So I'll be leaving the room.
Okay.
Thanks, Chair. Just for transvising members, I'd just like to declare a personal interest. I'm a volunteer trustee on World Food Bank, who operate in units at World Business Centre, which is listed for disposal of item 6. So, once you're not successful, you declare that.
Thank you. Thanks.
Yeah, same as Hans Davies, school government, for item 10.
And I will declare a non prejudicial interest in one of the asset disposals, which is 6. Matter of policy, it's my place of employment, but it's not everything by my employer. Phil?
Yes, I'm also a school governor which uses essential services.
Thank you. So, any more declarations of interest? Minutes. I invite members to approve the accuracy of the minutes. The meeting's held on the 14th of June 2023.
I just think the comment you made about the risk appetite assessments, I think it's obvious they've got a good response from Matthew Bennett, but I did say in the evening that it had started a discussion with Treasury Management, but it had broadened out to any investments. And I spoke to it in the previous agenda item, I did speak to the Treasury Management item. So just that one sentence would move, please, to reflect the item that I actually spoke to it, and the fact that I think you did say a couple of times that in March we started talking about Treasury Management, but we broadened it out to all investments.
Okay, thank you. With that amendment, our members happy to agree by assent. Thank you. Public in member questions. We have two public questions that have been submitted in advance of the meeting. Questioners will have a maximum of 2 minutes to ask their question and then a further minute to ask a supplementary question. This, however, must be related to the original question or in response to the answer provided. The first question is from Philip Barton on behalf of Tunnels Volunteers Limited. So, can I invite Mr. Philip Barton to answer this question?
Thank you. Council officers have been working with Tramway Tunnels Volunteers Limited and Birkenhead Tramway Community Benefit Society Limited to develop Tramway Tunnels as a major tourist attraction as part of Phase 2 of Birkenhead Dock Branch Initiative. Phase 2 will align with the proposed High Street Birkenhead Village are now engaged in examining detailed business plans submitted to them by two excellent community-minded groups. These two groups have spent a great amount of time and effort to complete these plans, which have already been assessed as good. The Friends of Rumble Library are ready to work with a successful group to create a community library to go partway to replace the library we have lost. We already have 1,800 books, funds and 21 or more volunteers. Rumble has already suffered greatly by the decision to close its library. This has already saved the council something like £250,000 per annum. We ask this committee to ensure that the cap process for Bromber Civic Centre and Library can continue to completion and ensure a positive outcome for the community of Bromber and its Civic Centre. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you very much for your statements.
Thanks very much for inviting me here tonight to make this statement. My name is Phil Simpson and I am the chairperson of Natural World and Greensby Greenbelt Action Group. On behalf of the said groups, I wish to read statements upon the strategic asset programme. It is noted through local media outlets that the sites included within the asset disposal are mainly brownfield sites, which is welcomed by our groups in principle. It is noted that the disposal of these assets will generate capital receipts, which are needed in a capitalisation programme. We also note that while selling these assets, that the council are obliged to obtain the best price for them. We note that Wirral waters are a factor in the housing land supply for the local plan. However, there will need to be more land available if we are to evidence-based brownfield and fair sites in the plan period. It is important that a sufficient amount of land can be brought forward where it is needed to address housing requirements. We further note that the number of homes proposed in the local plan are excessive and could be reduced. However, if the developers' consortium is convinced the government's inspectors that the plan is unsound, then there is a possibility that more houses could be built, put even more pressure on our precious green belt. To have the plan adopted by the inspectors of local authority has to show strategic policy making understanding of the land available in their area using the preparation of the strategic housing land availability assessment. We at Natural World and Greensby Greenbelt Action Group believe that this asset programme will be in part conducive to that process. Specific sites that have to be deliverable for years 1 to 5 of the plan period and specific developable sites for growth in years 6 to 10. This also applies, where possible, for years 11 to 15. It is recognised that small and medium sites can be a large contribution to meeting the housing requirements of an area. These sites in the asset programme form a good mix of sites and can be identified through a development plan and brownfield register. It is important that an authority such as Wirral Water Council does all it can to evidence brownfield sites and to protect our green belt. The council brownfield site policy is the right way forward. We must, at all costs, do all we can to protect our green belt for future generations. It is conducive to our climate change emergency. However, there are 4 sites that gives Natural World and Greensby Greenbelt Action Group some concern. Those sites are Ditton Lane, Morton. Our concerns are flooding and harm to biodiversity. We believe it should be part of a nature reserve for the area. Car Lane, Mells. This is greenbelt land, therefore not to be sold to a developer to build houses on under any circumstances. Clatterbridge Road, this is an amenity space for the local community and that is the way it should stay. Rock Ferry, Bedford Place, amenity ground, although overgrown sites in the programme, except for community asset transfers, are welcomed by us if they are to contribute to the 5-year housing land supply in the local plan. It is also essential that communities are involved in the decision-making process. We see it far too often where developers try to circumvent planning policy to build on greenbelt land. The two groups that I represent say brownfield must be first. So let us remind ourselves that Wirral Council has put forward a brownfield first local plan to protect Wirral's greenbelt, which is what all members of all parties supported. It is also the role of councillors to also support and protect that plan in their decisions. We will be watching any progress. I urge this committee here tonight to support the asset programme that protects the local plan, as well as being mindful of our concerns raised in the four sites that I have mentioned. Protect Wirral's green belt and open spaces. When it's gone forever. You cannot replace green belts, nor can you put something in its place. Green belt is natural, it is nature, and that's the way it must stay. Thank you for listening to me.
James Thomas Cadwallader.
James Thomas Cadwallader, please.
The Cadwallader name is Welsh, meaning Lord of the Apple. That's what my dad told me. Thank you.
Thank you.
Never done this before. Learn to be much Scotty. Guys, where are we up to? Could be back on Thursday, that might help. Right. Thank you for listening to my colleague. Tramway Tunnel, Volunteers Limited, is a company-wide guarantee set up in 2014 to facilitate actions toward tramway tunnels as a future all-weather attraction for the Wirral people and beyond. TTVL is a fully constituted volunteer group with its own bank account, accountant who submits our accounts to companies house every year. TTVL has 9 non-executive directors are working with the Wirral Council to include the project in Phase 2 of the Hind Street Urban Village. Tram Tunnel Volunteers Limited have completed a community consultation with some remarkable results to open tram tunnels to the wider public with the help of the regeneration team. Kathy Barber, Keith Cleary and the cultural officer Jane Morgan. And a massive thanks, guys, for your constant support. Retaining Holborn Square in the public ownership is essential for the success of tram tunnels project. As an established employment area, Holborn Square is very unlikely to contribute to a housing need for Wirral. The Tramway Tunnels project will enhance an area which will attract funding from National Lottery Fund and other funders with the help of the Wirral Council to complete a joint application. If we don't do a joint application, we will not get any money. TTVRC, list of assets for sale and time of the future Tramway Tunnels project has been determined. Tram Tunnels Volunteers Limited are very thankful to Holborn Square Campbell and as a transfer to Tram Tunnels Volunteers Limited. Please give this some thought. This has been a journey of a lifetime for me and a few others. My friend David Leighton died last year, who was a planner, financial, business, project leader. He was an excellent guy. Worked with me and a few others on the Tramway Hand Generation project going back to 2003. Tramway tunnels are the only people down there that have ever built for a ship of Wirral. Thankfully, it's Camel Earths. So, with your help and with your big trying to persuade you, we would like to carry on with the tramway tunnels project because in Holborn Square there are 2 entrances, possibly 3, and we have done a £10,000 survey in there one day with the help of David Ball, etc., etc., under license from the council. It took us 5 years to sort out the ownership of the tramway tunnels. I had to work with the Ministry of Justice, had to work with the Cabinet Office, had to work with Frank Field, and all those people I'd like to thank for helping me secure the Wirral Council ownership of the tunnels. They have qualified title, but one day we hope to up that qualified title to absolute title so the government can't come back and take it off us. Thank you very much for your time, panel, and this is a new experience for me. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your contributions.
item 3.12, the neighbourhood services, and there's the issue about neighbourhood safety and transport, and it said, let me have a look, sorry, my computer switched off. So the change delivery model for the community patrol services is less popular with schools, leading to negative variance. Why has this system changed, and are there any plans to move back?